Photoshop has no star tool. Weirdly, you go over here, you've got rectangle, ellipse, triangle tool, polygon tool, but no star tool. However, select the polygon tool, and then just go up here and go to the options and set a star ratio of something like 50%, and then apply the design. In Affinity Photo, you've got loads of star options. Just go over here to the various tools and go to rectangle. You can see down here, you've got star tool, you've got double star tool, you've got square star tool, and also you've got the cog tool, which can create all kinds of star designs as well. So just select one of those. So I'm just going to go for, say, double star, and then you can apply a double star very quickly that way. In Photoshop, you can go to the control bar and set a variety of different settings. You've got number of points for the star, as well as the roundness, and also the star ratio. So I'm going to go with these settings, and you can create a variety of different stars. And of course, you can set the color, stroke, etc. In Affinity Photo, you've got a number of options along the top, far more than in Photoshop. So you've got a number of points, inner radius, outer circle, inner circle, select new object, etc. But also, of course, you've got the other tools as well. So if I just apply it now, there's a very basic star design there. But you can modify the settings here. Just go up here and just change a variety of different settings like that. And again, because you've got the other tools as well, maybe go down there and select maybe the square star tool. Move that one, and you can see you can set that, and again, exactly the same, you can change a variety of settings. So there's a lot more settings and a lot more ways of creating a lot more stars in Affinity Photo. In Photoshop, there's some interactive features. There's just this control here, so you can just modify the roundness of your star. You can't modify the number of points. However, go to the properties panel, and you can see the settings there, so you can just change them, just change the number of points there, as well as the roundness, as well as the star ratio, maybe make it 20, etc. In Affinity Photo, you've got a number of settings along the top. You can modify along here, you can change the circle, inner circle, etc. But you can also modify them on the shape itself. So you can just go to the shape and you can change them here. So a lot more flexibility, I think, in Affinity Photo for interactive changes. However, you still can't modify the number of actual points in this. So you can just do that. And there you can see these little red dots. But again, you can still go up here and just modify this very quickly to create all kinds of different designs. In Photoshop, you can change the color of the fill very simply by just going over here to the fill, as long as you've got the polygon tool, etc., selected. You can also set stroke and other things. You can also change the color over here in the properties panel. And also you can, if you want, double click the actual layer itself. So you can change the color, you can add strokes. So I'm just going to change the stroke there so you can see it. So like that. That also can be like gradients or patterns. So you can simply go onto the stroke color there and you can see you've got a variety of different options. So gradients as well as pattern designs, which you can add to your design. You've also got dashes as well. So you've got here strokes, dashes like that. So you can create a variety of different designs. In Affinity Photo, what you can do, you can also change the color. You can just go up here with the shape selected and just go to fill, click there, and it will bring up the panel there and you can modify the color. You've also got the option for gradient as well. So if you want to add a gradient, or just go to the gradient tool and apply a gradient very quickly. And of course you can modify that in numerous ways. Also what you can do is you can change a stroke as well. So you can add a stroke and you can increase that. We've also got the option for like pressure, which is something that Photoshop does not have. Though you could potentially do it via Illustrator, because that's got like this curve. You can just modify the design there. You can create a variety of different strokes, which I think are quite nice to give it a more sort of unusual design there. And of course, all these are still interactive and you can modify them at the same time as well. You can also, if you wish, bring in dashes as well. So you can just go here to dashes and you can set a variety of different dash designs. You've also got the option for arrows as well. So you create some nice arrow designs with this. You've also got a brush option, though in this case, you do need Affinity Designer, so you can bring in vector brushes around your design, which you can then continue to modify. In Photoshop, if you've got an older version of Photoshop, you can use the 3D features. Many of the 3D features now have been removed. So you've got here 3D, you can do extrusions as well as meshes, etc. from these star designs. Sadly, in 2022, many of those features are being removed. In Affinity Photo, there is a slight 3D feature, and that's via layers. You go over here to effects, click there, and you can go down to 3D, make certain you select that, click there, and you can see there's a 3D feature. Now, it's not the world's greatest 3D feature, doesn't make any extrusions, etc. It'd be great if it did, but sadly, it doesn't. There's a variety of different options you can see with 3D-like effects. Of course, with both these applications, what you can also do is you can maybe use Blender or another 3D application and bring that in. Of course, 3D options are available via Creative Cloud if you've got that for Photoshop. Photoshop allows you to create shapes in a variety of formats: shape, path, and pixels. So if I want to, I can create it a vector shape. Also, I can create a path which has no fill or stroke, etc. And also, you've got pixels. So I can select pixels, and the star will be added to the current layer, the background, etc. And you can apply it multiple times using that very quickly and easy, and you can change the color, etc. Now, unfortunately, Affinity Photo applies the shape only as a shape layer. If you want to use it as a pixel layer, what you need to do is simply go over to layer and maybe use merge visible, etc., or rasterize. So rasterize, and then you can turn it into a pixel layer, and then you can apply various brush strokes, etc. So it's not, for me personally, as flexible. It's a feature that I would love to see in Affinity Photo, the ability to actually apply it to the current pixel layer. That would be really useful. In Photoshop, you can turn any shape, like a star, into a smart object. As a smart object, you can apply various filters, which are live filters, so you can modify them later. So simply just go over here to filter and down to any of these filters, so say box blur, and it will turn it into a smart object. Now, you could use it, of course, as a rasterized design as well. But the thing is with this, it means you can modify the design, the star design, create all kinds, and all of the various filters are available as smart filters or smart objects with filters. And you can modify them at any point simply via the layers panel. So just go to window and layers. And you can see there you've got smart filters. And you can just simply click on that and modify the box blur. In Affinity Photo, if you want to apply, there's no smart filters or smart objects. However, there is an option for live layers. However, if you go to filters now, if you just go to filters, say distort or deform, as soon as you do that, say deform, it turns it into a pixel layer, which is fine if that's what you want, but it's no longer a vector design that you can modify. So you've just got your standard pixel layer that you can modify. However, there is, as I mentioned, so you've got, again, back to the vector design, you can go to layer and new live filter layer, and there's a variety of ones, say blur and Gaussian blur. However, you will notice that there's not so many filters available in the live filter. Not all of the filters are available, like deform, etc. But many are. So you can apply it, box blur, say again, apply the effect, and you can see as you do that, you've got the effect applied there. And actually, sometimes some of the effects are quite different in Affinity Photo to Photoshop. So you might look at it and think, oh, that doesn't look exactly the same as it did in Photoshop. But you've also got blending modes, which is really quite nice feature here, as well as opacity you can apply. And you can see over here in the layers, you can see your thing. It's exactly the same as smart filters in many ways. So it's just, but it's unfortunately not every feature is available for use. In Photoshop, you can change your star design into just a normal vector star. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to quickly go over here to direct selection tool. You can find that in the tools panel. Select that and simply go to these points and modify them. And as soon as you do that, that's it. It's no longer a polygon tool that you can modify. So you can just modify these points and create a variety of different star designs simply by using the direct selection tool. You can also add points to it, modify it using the various other pen tools, etc. In Affinity Photo, you need to convert it first. So it's no automatic. So if I go to the node tool, it will not work. So I need to go to convert to curves. So click there. Once you've done that, that's it. It's no longer a vector star. It's just a standard curve or path, as in Photoshop. So you go over here, select the node tool, and you've got the node tool, and you can modify a variety of different points this way, or nodes, and you've got a variety of different actions. Quite a lot of great features here. You've got very smoothing, loads of different features that you can use. I think it's actually quite flexible and useful once you've converted it to that curve. Is it better than Photoshop in terms of modifying and creating different stars? I don't know. Personally, you might be happier with Photoshop's approach or with Fenty Photo's approach. But you can create a variety of different designs with both. In Photoshop, if you want to create a very unusual design, what you can also do is simply go over to the polygon tool or circle tool, etc. Doesn't have to be a star. And then simply create another star design, maybe with different points. And once you've done that, you can just drag that over there, create that, press return, select both of the shapes, and then go to layer and down to combine shapes and unite shapes. And now once you've done that, you've got all the points there selected, you can then go over here and you can go to merge shape components, and then you've got your star design, an unusual star design. In Affinity Photo, what you can do, go over here, again, it could be a star or circle or any other shape, select that and then just create another design there. And in this case, I'm gonna add a few more points there, go there, and with that, both selected. Now I could align them, just gonna align them just like that. Once you've done that, you do go to layer and down to geometry and add. And then you see, again, you've got an unusual star design, slightly more different. However, of course, it's not a star in terms of the standard star. It's just been turned into a curve. Still a vector design though. Personally for me, I think Affinity Photo wins out. It's got a lot more tools. It's got the interactive features. You've got the pressure settings, the node tool, lots of great features in Affinity Photo. Photoshop doesn't even have a star tool. It's combined with the polygon tool. I mean, I hope at some point that they bring out a star tool, a dedicated star tool that brings a load of features. And I think there's a crying out for some great star features. Please put in the comments below what you think. Do you think that the star tool, or polygon tool, I should say, in Photoshop is better than Affinity Photo's ones or not? Also, what sort of things would you love to see in the star tool? Are there other features that you would love to see in it? Because, I mean, I've used Star Tool for quite a while in different applications, and I'm always thinking, well, it'd be great if it could do this or that. So please put in the comments below what you would like to see. Also, one feature that really, in Photoshop, was always great is the 3D feature. Sadly, that's gone now, and I was often using maybe creating 3D stars, etc. So that's, again, a slight loss in terms of Photoshop for me. However, I think both are great, both work okay, and quite a lot of the time I work with Illustrator and create my star and designs in there. And of course, that's a lot more flexible for creating all kinds of designs, and then I can import it into Photoshop. But I think in this case, Affinity Photo, for me, certainly wins out. Well, I hope you found this of interest. Comments below, always great to hear. Thank you much.